What is going on, everybody? It's your boy Nathan Muskills, and in today's video we are going to be talking about the big gear changes that were announced in this last state of the game. If you haven't watched my full video on the full coverage of that last state of the game, I'll put a link down below. But in this one, I just wanted to focus on gear updates. So this is going to be a three-part series. We're going to do gear updates, loot rotations, and then recalibration and crafting. And this is all title update 6. But I know I had a lot of questions on what does this actually mean. A lot of you guys were a little bit confused, so I wanted to get into it. So this is what they had to say.
Yeah, we made sure that all of the brands now have items in all of the slots. So you no longer need to have like these particular brands for these slots and these particular brands for those slots. Mm-hmm. So that would make it easier to just like make different builds because you have more flexibility in terms of combining items.
Okay, so I just cut it off right there. Point being, they said that all brand sets will be able to use every single slot. Now a lot of you guys are like, whoa, what does that mean? What does that mean? Okay, so some of these gear pieces, besides Gilligard, can be rolled into every single piece, right? We all know that. You can have a mask, you can have a holster, you can have knee pads, you can have gloves, and you can have a backpack. All Gilligard, right? 100% that one rolls in all the pieces, but pieces like Araldi do not. And I don't think I have anything on here with Araldi, so I think Araldi rolls backpack, gloves, and holster. It doesn't have a knee pad, it doesn't have a chest, and it doesn't have a mask. So in future updates, in title update 6, what they're going to be doing is now every single brand set you see here besides 511, so China Light, Providence, Yao, Alp Summit, Petrov, which Petrov doesn't have gloves, you will now be able to get 6 pieces of every single brand set in the game. So all of these pieces right here, these Araldi pieces, all will have 6 pieces available. Now this is game changer for the Division 2, because a lot of times when you're creating these builds, right, you're making different builds, you're playing with different builds. So you have this build here, you're trying to mix and match pieces, but the problem is, well, Petrov doesn't roll gloves, right? But you want to have a one-piece Petrov. Now, I don't have to run the chest piece, I can run something else, and I can run Petrov gloves instead of this Providence gloves. So this two-piece Providence is really hurting me, but in the next update, this can all change, right? This can all change, and that's what I'm really excited for. I think this is going to change build diversity. We'll still have our one exotic piece we can put on, but now with all of these other pieces, we can have Badger Tough that's not a mask and then it's not gloves. We can get Badger Tough knee pads, Badger Tough chest. That can all be rolled into all 6 pieces. And the only brand that you're not going to be able to do this is this 511 set. And that's because 511, remember, they're a real brand in the real world, and you can actually buy 511 stuff. I have a couple 511 items. I have 511 gloves. I have a 511 backpack from back in the day when I was in the military. I had 511 stuff, so I ended up buying those. They do have certain stuff, but they don't make all the pieces. So 511 will only still be on the pieces that they make. Now, the great thing about this is gonna allow players to create some crazy, crazy builds. And I'm so excited for this. I'm so excited for this small change right here. And not only that, what they said about gear sets.
For gear sets, we're making sure that you only need 4 items to make the set complete, so to unlock all of the bonus from the gear set. Mm-hmm. So again, it takes fewer items to put something together.
Now, for green gear sets, you only need 4 pieces to unlock the full set. I think what they're going to end up doing is, for weapon handling accuracy, they'll put that under 1 piece. Under 2 piece, they'll have the 10% marks from rifle damage. Under 3 piece, that's where you'll get the dead man's hand. And then the 4th piece will give you Sheriff's Favor. You will be able to unlock a 6 piece Aces and Eights with only 4 pieces. And that works with Tip of the Spear, Ongoing Directive, which you see right here. And that is a huge game changer for green gear sets. And I can't wait to see the different builds, diversity that we're going to be having coming up, everybody's build ideas. It's going to be great for builds and everybody who likes creating different builds, because there's just going to be so many ways you can roll this. So you can still have a 4-piece Aces and Eights and still run a Petrov or a Alp Summit, Providence, Gilligard. You can run all of these pieces and still pair it up with the Aces and Eights 4-piece and then even run like an exotic holster. That's just giving ideas. There's going to be so many ways you can make different builds once we get the full breakdown of how they're going to run this. Also, another thing that they're doing to the green gear sets.
We're also making the chest and the backpack a little bit more powerful by adding a high-end talent that usually rolls on those slots.
On the chest piece and the backpack, they will have a high-end talent. Now, this doesn't get any better than that, right? So you're going to have your high-end talent, your attributes, and have the four-piece. That's why I think build diversity is going to come back. A lot of different builds are going to be dropping. Chest pieces are going to be crazy. Being able to run ongoing directive with a talent, and then also being able to run a four-piece with two other really good pieces. So many people are going to start running these gear sets, and that's what I can't wait to see. All this build diversity that should be coming with title update 6. Now, one other thing they did want to say is chest pieces and backpacks for all gear sets will be made more powerful in addition to that high-end talent. So I can see that being a plus, because I was thinking that too. I was like, well, even with that, if they don't make them more powerful, people are still going to run like a Gilligard for the extra mod slots, right? Well, they're changing that. So that alone, I could see these gear sets, these green gear sets coming back and being a lot better. Now, what they did say is, so tip of the spear, aces and eights, you know, raid gear sets.
We do want to make the raid gear sets widely available to everyone so that they can play with those and put them together. But the backpack and the chest will still remain exclusive to the raid.
So you'll be able to get them not just in the raid. So if we look at the map, the only place you can get these right now is in the raid, but they are going to change this. So every piece but the chest and backpack will drop in the world. They haven't said exactly where they're going to put them, but the chest and backpack will still only drop in the raid, but the other pieces will drop all around. So that's what we're waiting to see, what they're going to do, where they're going to add them. Are they going to put them in heroic missions? Are they going to put them just as random drops that can come from any boss? We don't know yet, but what we do know is they will be available. Right now, all those pieces are only available in the raid. That's going to change, and you'll be able to get them in the open world. Not sure what missions, if they have to be invaded missions or what, but they will be available in the open world and even possibly the DZ. Now, one other thing they are going to be doing is, if we look right here, let me see. So these named weapons right here, you know, we have a couple of them and they have talents, right? This one has boomerang on it. And it says critical hits have 50% chance to return the bullet to the magazine. If the bullet is returned to the magazine, the next shot has 20% increased damage. So say that's the standard for all rifles, right? If you get boomerang on another rifle that's not a named rifle, it has the same exact stat. Whoa, they did say they are going to be making this a little bit more powerful. So say this boomerang on a regular rifle says 50%. Well, on here, it might say critical hits have a 75% chance to return the bullet to the magazine. And then it says if the bullet does return, well, then instead of that 20% increased damage, you get 50% increased damage. So that is, they said that it's going to have a fixed talent that's going to be more powerful than anything you see, but then it'll have a random bottom two talent. So the extra 20% magazine, you can have a leg roll there instead, and transmission can be stop, drop, and roll. Those talents will be random. But on the named weapons, this one's going to be fixed, but it's going to be the most powerful fixed. So they want the fixed weapons to be more powerful, and they're going to be bringing named gear pieces. So they'll have a Badge of Tough named gear piece. I'm just saying an example. They haven't gave what brand set they're going to use, but say if this brand set was, this was Badge of Tough, they would call it Skills Badge of Tough. And then it would have a talent on there that's going to be more powerful. Say if it had a talent on there, it would be more powerful than what you would see on another regular Badge of Tough piece. So they did say that they were going to be coming with named weapons and named gear pieces, and they're going with a total of 35. So 35 total named pieces that, and I think right now we only have a couple, but 35 total named pieces, including weapons and gear. So I can't wait to see what they're going to be dropping. And that wraps up pretty much everything I wanted to talk about gear updates. So episode 1 was all on gear updates. We talked about the brand sets. Remember, all 6 pieces will have a chance of having the brand sets. The green gear sets will have a talent on the chest and the backpack will have a talent, and then it will require only 4 pieces to unlock the 6-piece set that we see now. So 4 pieces, all you need to unlock the 6-piece sets that you currently see on your green gear sets. Raid gear pieces will now be in the open world. Remember, so in the open world, raid gear pieces will drop, except the chest and backpack, only in Operations Dark Hours. New name, weapon, and gear, 35 new items going to be dropping. I can't wait to see what's going on with this. Let me know what you guys think about this on gear updates. More to come. Remember, loot rotation and recalibration and crafting will be dropping on this channel. We will have a 3-part series for title update 6, loot, gear, and crafting. So hopefully I guys see you. If you guys enjoy these videos, these more in-depth videos, leave a thumbs up. As always, if you have any questions, any feedback, use the comment section down below. Thank you guys again for all the support. But until the next Division 2 video, nothing but skills is out.